Hello friends, let's discuss a crucial topic of marketing, that is STP, segmentation, targeting and positioning. Why we require the concept of STP in marketing? All the market buyers are not same. Their demands, their needs, their expectation from the organizations are different. Therefore, mass marketing cannot be applied. Mass marketing means having one marketing plan and applying the same to all. As we know, every individual is unique, same as the case with buyers in the market. So we need the concept of STP. Companies cannot connect with all the customers in the diverse markets. So what they have to do is, they have to divide the market into various groups on the basis of different criteria such as needs, and then they have to focus upon the relevant segments. In order to know the customers and their buying behavior, the process of STP is very crucial. Whenever the company wants to design a marketing strategy, it has to go for segmentation, targeting, and positioning. Let us discuss what segmentation is. According to the marketing guru Philip Kotler, no company in its right mind tries to sell to everyone, because you cannot make everyone satisfied. Therefore, you have to divide the market into various groups of buyers who have distinct needs, who might require different products, and then you have to focus upon the relevant persons. What does segmentation means? Segmentation means dividing the mass market into small markets or fragmenting the mass market into subsets. How we have to divide the market? We have to divide our market or our customers on the basis of their needs and wants. Then we have to design the marketing strategy accordingly. So, segmentation is grouping the consumers on the basis of certain criteria in such a way that those within a group will respond to your marketing action in the same way. Let's take an example. If we talk about Nivea, the sun protection products are there, so they are focused upon the women segment of the market. Market segmentation can be done on the basis of benefits also. This company has divided the market on the basis of skin type, like very light, fair skin, normal skin, dark skin, or children. On the basis of climate also, like you can apply the product in the winter season, in the summer season, and all that. Now the need for segmentation. Why we do the segmentation? Why we divide the market into various segments? Because the entire market rarely has the same tastes and preferences. It is difficult to handle all the demands, tastes and preferences. Therefore, we have to make a precise definition of the market, divide the market and then focus upon the best ones. Another reason is the company does not have unlimited resources and you have to go ahead with those limited resources. Therefore, segmentation is a must. By segmentation, you can better assess the competition. Instead of scattering the marketing efforts, companies must focus on those who have greater probability of satisfaction from your product. Now the features of segmentation. We can divide the market on various criteria, but whenever you divide the market, there is a need that there should be homogeneity within the segment. There should be heterogeneity among different segments. Marketing segments that we are creating should be measurable and identifiable. The segments that the company is designing must be large enough to generate profits, and the segments should be accessible and actionable. Therefore, we can say SADAM model applies for segmentation. That is, our segment should be substantial, accessible, differential, actionable, and measurable. Importance of segmentation can be seen from these points. It gives more precise definition of the market. It leads to maximum customer satisfaction. It results in effective marketing strategy. Segmentation is the essence of modern marketing. It has a positive impact upon your profitability. It helps in optimum utilization of the organizational product. It also offers the benefit of specialization and high competitiveness. The valuable information about the customers can be collected via segmentation. We can identify the right marketing opportunity. Of course, it provides benefits to society as well as nation and small scale industrial unit, as they can focus upon small segments. Now, on the basis of customer preferences, the segmentation can be of different types. Like, we can have segmentation based upon the homogeneous preferences. There can be diffused preferences and there can be clustered preferences. So we can divide the market on the basis of the segments. Coming to the types of marketing segmentation. Now, segmentation can be demographic, psychographic, behavioral, or geographic. Demographic means when we are dividing the market on the basis of certain demographic features. Like, we are dividing the market on the basis of age, child, adult, adolescent, old age. Like this, we are dividing the market. On the basis of marital status, the segmentation can be married, unmarried. On the basis of gender, segmentation can be male, female, transgender, or others. On the basis of ethnic background also, we can divide the market, and on the basis of income as well. So these are the certain demographic features on the basis of segments can be designed. Coming to the psychographic segmentation, here the segmentation is done on the basis of some psychological aspects like personality and values of the individuals, attitudes of the individuals, activities in which the individual is connected to. In behavioral segmentation, how the customer behaves regarding a product, according to that, segmentation can be done. On the basis of benefits sought from the product, on the basis of usage rates that customer has, and on the basis of behavioral patterns, we can divide the market. Coming to geographics, we can divide the market on the basis of areas like local markets, national market, international market, and regional market. Therefore, there can be different criteria for marketing segmentation. Coming to the consumer characteristics, as we discussed, we can divide the market on the basis of demographic, psychographic, and geographic segmentation. On the basis of customer response, we can divide the market on the basis of user status, user rate, benefit, and occasion. On the basis of loyalty status, we can see that there can be different types of loyalty towards the organizational product. Some consumers are hardcore loyals, while some are softcore loyals, some are shifting loyals, and some are switchers. So whenever you are dividing the market into a segment, the segment should be identifiable, accessible, substantial, it should be unique, measurable, should offer you a profit, durable, and should match with the organizational capabilities and objectives and strategic intent. Coming to the second part of our STP, that is targeting. Now, you have divided the market in various segments, but you cannot fulfill the need of each and every segment. You have to focus upon one segment, that is known as your target market. Target market means the group of individuals that are separated by distinguishable and noticeable market segmentation. What is targeting a market segment? When you are actually selecting a segment that you want to serve. Target marketing tailors a marketing mix for one or more segments which are identified through the marketing segmentation process. So whenever you are selecting a target market, keep two things in mind. The segment should be attractive and it should be suitable with your objectives, resources, and capabilities. A market segment that we are targeting should be sizable. It should have the chances of growth in the future. There should be competition in the market. The brand loyalty should be there. It should give you a required market share. It should offer a smart sales potential. There should be expected profits, and cost of reaching the segment should be as minimal as possible. Suitability of the market to the firm. Market segments are also should be evaluated according to how they fit the firm's objectives, resources, and capabilities. Some aspects of fit include whether the firm can offer superior value to the customers in the segment, the impact of serving the segment on the firm's image, access to distribution channels required to serve the segment, the firm's resources versus capital investment required to serve the segment, better the firm's fit to market segment, and more attractive the market segment, the greater will be the profit potential for the firm. Now, whenever you are selecting a target market, we have various strategies. First is concentrated marketing strategy. It means when you are not focusing on the whole market, but some segments are to be focused. Here we can focus upon single segment, that is Nike marketing. We can go for selective specialization, and we can go for product specialization. Let's discuss the first point in detail, that is concentrated marketing strategy. Now, this is a concentrating marketing strategy when we are depending on certain target markets. The first case is single segment. From the entire market, left side products have been shown, and the above, the segments have been shown. So P1, P2, P3 shows the product, and S1, S2, S3 shows the segments. So when you are focusing on one segment, it is known as single segment. Second is selective specialization. When in every segment you are focusing upon a different product, it is known as selective specialization. Coming to product specialization, when you are specialized in a product and the same product is offered in all the segments. In market specialization, you focus upon one segment and you offer different products in that segment only. In the full market coverage, you want to satisfy the needs of each and everyone in the market. So this was the first case, that is concentrated marketing segment, in which we discussed single segment concentration, selective specialization, and product specialization. Coming to second point, that is undifferentiating marketing strategy. Here the whole market is served with one offer. The same marketing mix is offered to the whole market. That is why it is known as undifferentiated marketing strategy. The third one is differentiating marketing strategy. Here every segment is offered a different marketing mix. Marketing mix stands for 4 P's, that is product, price, place, and promotion. So every segment is considered to be a crucial segment and a different marketing mix is offered in each segment. Now the difference between differentiated marketing strategy of targeting and concentrated marketing strategy of targeting. Targeting different segments using individual marketing mixes is known as differentiated market targeting, while targeting just one segment with unique marketing mix is known as concentrated market targeting. Differentiated market targeting is appropriate when company is financially strong, while concentrated market targeting is appropriate when company is small and newly established. So we can see n number of examples in our day-to-day world, the companies which are focusing upon segmentation as well as targeting. And McDonald's is the best example. For them, the target market is males and females both, and they are focusing on different income groups. So we can see their geographical coverage, demographic coverage, behavioral and psychographic, how they have segmented the market through this slide. Even other companies like Zara, Apple, Samsung, HTC, all the companies are indulging into segmentation as well as targeting. Coming to the third point of our STP process, that is positioning. So positioning, according to Philip Kotler, is the act of designing company's offer and image in such a way that it occupies a distinct and valued place in the target customer's minds. It means the customer is unable to forget your product as it has been positioned in the person's brain. If you think about any advertisement that you would have seen on the TV and you can never forget that because of the emotional connect that advertisement has created with you. This is what companies are doing by their positioning strategies. So you have to create a face in the crowd. You have to be different in the crowd. You have to stand out from the competitors. And if you have good positioning or you have a good tagline, brand, your photos, your product is positioned in the mind of customers, it means you have a foot in the present and a foot in the future. So creating a compelling, well-differentiated position, it requires a keen understanding of the customer needs, capabilities, and competitive actions. So positioning is developing a product and brand image in the minds of the customers as compared to competitors' product. So companies use positioning strategies to distinguish their products and services from competitors and to design communications that convey the desired positions to customers and prospects in the chosen markets. So various objectives are there due to which we go for this positioning, that is to create a distinctive place in the minds of customers, to provide a competitive edge, place intangible service with more tangible frame of reference to give target market the reason for availing your product or service, and helping the marketers in determining the price. So how we do the positioning? We identify our competitors, determine how the competitors are perceived and evaluated in the market, and then we will determine our position. We will analyze what the customer wants. We will create a positioning decision, and finally we will monitor the positioning. On the basis of different criteria, we can position. First is attribute positioning. It means you are using product or service attributes to position, like how Airtel 4G services are being offered. Quality positioning, when you are providing such quality products that are being positioned in the minds of consumers. Competitive positioning, it means positioning on the basis of competition or competitors' service offerings, like how airlines do. Service benefits, on the basis of your distinct benefits, you are positioning yourself in the minds of customers. Leadership positioning, here you aim to communicate the consumer that you are a leader in the market. In case of excellence positioning, because of your excellent performance and efficiency, your products gets positioned in the minds of customers. So whenever you are thinking about any emotional positioning, just keep this thing in mind that positioning is full-fledged connected with emotional positioning. You have to be rational, but you should provide emotional positioning. It means you have to connect with your customers emotionally. So you have to aim at their emotional needs. For example, if you see any advertisements in which mother is being connected, those ads are stuck up in the minds of the customers as the emotional needs are being focused. So if we see in case of Star Plus, it was having earlier sign of purple color. Nowadays Star Plus has come up with a sign of red color. So what Star Plus is trying to do, it is trying to reposition itself. Reposition means when the company see that the product or service is going on the maturity stage or decline, we try to reposition the product in the minds of customer by making certain changes. As Star Plus has recognized that red is most important color for Indian society. So it's a color of life, festivals, family, marriage, positivity. So what they have done, they have come up with this color and they have changed their logo, and that red looks great on their broadcast. So different companies are using these strategies time to time. So these are very powerful tools that marketers are using these days to have a brand equity in the market along with product differentiation. Thanks a lot.